Okay. Check, 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 check. Check, check, check. I request all the kids.
Check, check.
Check, check.
Check,
check, check. Check.
Okay, all the Sunday school kids, all the beginners to seniors, can we have all of you all in front of the stage, please? Come, 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 come. I can see a few of them at the back.
All of you in the front.
All the boys sitting in front. Hi, come. The kids at the back, inter seniors, can I have you all in front of the stage? Yes, right? So we'll have one last round of worship, praise and worship session. Okay, all the girls and boys at the back. Come, come. Okay, how many of you all are excited today? Yes. Okay, let's ask the band. Is the band excited? Okay, everybody on stage, are you all excited?
Yes.
Are you all excited? A louder yes, guys. Are you all excited? All right. Okay, today is the last, is that, what is today? Why are you all here? Annual day, right? So this is the last time that we are going to have a time of praise and worship, yes?
Yes.
Do you all want to do it with all your hearts?
Yes.
Who are you all doing it for?
Yes.
Who are you all doing it for? Jesus, right? Okay, we'll do Hey You. Hands on top, everybody.
Hey you,
Guys, this is the last time that we are going to do. Yes?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Is the band ready?
You are my way, Jesus. Every breath I take, I breathe in you.
We'll do a fun song, okay? If I request all the parents also to join us. So if I request all of you all to stand. Yes. All the beginners in primary, you'll have to go to the front. All the juniors, please come back. All of you all are tall. All the primary and beginners in the front. Okay, can I request all the... Hi, good evening, parents. Good evening, everybody. I think this is very sad. Okay, let's ask the kids. Hi, kids. Good evening. Hey, y'all can do a louder job. Come on. Good evening. Okay. Parents, good evening. Okay. I would like to ask y'all to join us also. We are going to sing a very simple song. It's I'm Trading My Sorrows. So if y'all can join with us, that'd be great. Yes. All the kids, yes. Okay, let's go.
Shame. I'm laying it down for the joy of the Lord.
Louder, louder. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, now we have the Ten Commandments. Come.
The Ten Commandments. In the Old Testament, we read that as God commanded, Moses led the Israelites out of the Egyptian bondage. During their journey in the wilderness, the Lord gave the Ten Commandments to the Israelites. The Ten Commandments can be understood as a moral guidebook to life. Our Sunday school children will now recite the Ten Commandments in one voice. In the New Testament, we read that Christ came into this world to establish the law through His amazing grace. Jesus has summed up the Ten Commandments into two greatest commandments.
Okay, can we do the Ten Commandments now? Can we recite it? Okay, let's do the first. What is the first one? Okay, the second one? Continue. The third one? The fourth one? The fifth one? The sixth one. Can you do that a little louder? Seven. Eighth one. The ninth one. And the last one.
In the Old Testament, we read that Christ came into this world. Came into this world to establish the law through His amazing grace. Jesus has summed up the Ten Commandments into two greatest commandments.
Okay, so what are the two greatest commandments? What's the first one? Can we do that together a little louder? Okay, the second one?
I think all the kids can sit down now. Good evening, everyone. I want to thank the worship team for doing such a great job. Welcome to the Sunday School Annual Day 2024. We are so glad you could join us.
Smarna and I are the hosts for tonight, later joined by JC and Evelyn.
On behalf of the entire Sunday School, I now welcome Reverend Dr. U. Pastor Daniel Garu and Reverend E. Sumalata. Please accept these flowers as a token of our appreciation. Thank you, pastors. I now invite Pastor Reverend Sumalata to kickstart the program with an opening prayer.
Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Shall we all bow down our heads and look to the Lord in prayer? Master, we thank and praise you, Lord, for the blessed evening that you have blessed us with. To be in your presence, to enjoy your presence, Lord, among all our friends and families who are gathered here, Lord, to celebrate Lord Master Annual Day of St. John the Baptist Sunday School. Thank you, Lord Master Father God, for the wisdom, for the guidance that you have given to the superintendent and our team of teachers, volunteers, who worked all through the year, Lord Master, nurturing your children in godly discipline. And Lord Master, bless, and Lord Master Father God, bringing all of us this day to celebrate this annual day. As all the children are here, Lord, bless them, Lord. Be with them, Lord Master Father God. We are thankful for their lives, and thank you for the parents and grandparents who have taken keen interest in sending their children, Lord Master, to the Sunday school. Bless them too, Lord. We also pray for the ones who are yet to join us for this celebration. Bring them safely amongst us, Lord. And as we begin this annual day program, let your spirit be with us, let your guidance, and you take control of the entire program from the starting till the end, and you be honored and glorified through the service that all of us are rendering to you, Lord. Be magnified and exalted this evening through the time that you have given us, Lord, in coming together to celebrate your love and grace amidst us. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity and the blessed time. We ask all these things in the blessed name of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Amma, for the prayer. Now I invite Yana for the scripture reading for this evening.
The scripture reading will be taken from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 19, verses 13 to 15. Then were there brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. But Jesus said, Suffer little children, and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And he laid his hands on them and departed thence.
Thank you, Yana. I now invite Reverend Dr. Yu Pastor Garu to share with us the word of God.
I thank God Almighty for the wonderful time God has given us to celebrate the Sunday School Annual Day. I appreciate the children for the wonderful presentation on the stage. And very specially, I appreciate the superintendent and all the teachers and the team, the way they have encouraged the children to prepare for this annual day. I very specially, on behalf of all the children, thank the parents and grandparents, and also teachers, the way you are nurturing for the children for the glory of God Almighty. And wonderful thing you have planned, rejoice when we experience the presence of God in our lives. We always rejoice when we connect ourselves to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We rejoice. So having Jesus Christ in our hearts, in our families, in our personal lives, certainly bring in rejoice or happiness and joy by the grace of God Almighty. I wish you all a happy Sunday School Annual Day, children. All will respond by saying thank you. All will say thank you.
Thank you.
Are you all happy by this?
Yes.
Sunday School Annual Day is a great celebration for the glory of God. Do you believe this? Yeah, if you believe this, you join your hands and clap and glorify God Almighty as a mark of thanksgiving to God. The goal of the Sunday School is to lead every child to a personal commitment to follow Jesus Christ through a medium of Christian worship, Christian nurturing, Bible study, and songs and memory verses, and etc. The Sunday school deals with the life and soul, the inspiration of the individual for a lifetime. I thank and appreciate the superintendent, the teachers, parents and grandparents for your kind contribution and dedicated service to nurture the children of our blessed congregation for the glory of God Almighty. The annual Sunday school day is a celebration of thanking God for his blessings and continuous blessings upon our children, upon the ministry of Sunday school in our church, in our congregation. First of all, I would like to remind all the parents and grandparents, all the teachers, that children are the gift from God Almighty. As it is written in Psalms 127, chapter 3, children are the gift from God. They are the real blessings. They are the heritage. These little children belongs to God Almighty. God, through His grace, He has gifted these beautiful and little children to the parents and also to the congregation with the purpose to nurture the children for the glory of God Almighty. Dear teachers and the whole team of Sunday school, remember that you are called to nurture these little children for the glory of God Almighty. You are chosen for the glory of God. You are called by the glory of God. God has given you a wonderful opportunity to cater the needs, the spiritual needs of these little children for the glory of God. Therefore, I really appreciate you on behalf of the pastoral committee and the officers and all the clergy. I really appreciate you the way you are rendering your committed service for the glory of God in nurturing spiritually these little children. As we celebrate the annual day 2024, let us remember and count the blessings of God upon the ministry of our congregation, very especially the Sunday school. God has blessed our Sunday school and is giving His gracious presence on every Sunday in the Sunday school, making every child to experience the mighty presence of God through His word. And also God is making every year VBS a grand success. And God has really blessed our children to witness in the whole diocese of Medak and also in different denominations at various levels by their participation and bringing laurel to our blessed congregation. And even now the blessed children will witness before us their spiritual talents learned in the Sunday school. It is all because of God's grace and because of God's mercy. Therefore, the annual day is a time where we all thank God Almighty for His blessings, for His spiritual blessings upon all the children and the way God has anointed the Sunday school staff in nurturing these little children. It's a time to thank God Almighty. Children, you're staging the program, your dances, your singing is a mark of thanksgiving to God Almighty for His blessings upon you, the way God has blessed you spiritually in all aspects of your life journey. Whenever you and me, we experience God's mighty grace, we must express our gratitude to God Almighty by thanking God. Psalmist 105 very clearly says, begins with verse 1, "Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim His greatness, tell nations what He has done. Sing praise to the Lord, tell of the wonderful things He has done." The staging of the program certainly witnesses what all they have learned in the Sunday school. And it is not just witnessing on the stage in a way. They are glorifying and thanking God for the mercy and grace of God that they have received by the grace of God in the nurturing, the process of nurturing in the Sunday school. In Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20 says, Jesus very clearly commanded, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, teach them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you." This is a particular verse where the whole world was motivated to lay the foundation for the Sunday school. John Wesley, the forerunner of the Sunday school, Robert Riggs, the founder of the Sunday school, Francis Scott Key, the state man for the Sunday school, Stephen Paxson, spirit of Sunday school, and also the Modi, the supporter of the Sunday school, Yell Modi. These all were inspired by this particular word, particular commandment of God Almighty, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who said, we read in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 28, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, teach them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. Dearly beloved people of God, as we all gathered here to celebrate the annual day, remember that God has called us and anointed us with a great responsibility to sustain and strengthen and empower the kingdom of God in the lives of these little children. Therefore, it's a time to thank God. It's a time to praise God Almighty. I request all the parents and the grandparents to kindly lift up your hands and clap and glorify God for the way God has anointed the congregation. God has anointed the Sunday school teachers and volunteers in nurturing these little children. These are the kingdom of God. That's what Jesus Christ very clearly explained. Therefore, it is the time to thank God Almighty. Secondly and lastly, the annual Sunday school day is a time to remember the direction of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who said, "Let the children come to me. Do not hinder them." This is very, very important. Let the children come to me. Do not hinder them. God wants the children to know about Him. God wants the children to know about the sin in the world. God wants the children to learn about His unconditional grace. God wants the children to learn about His teachings, His wisdom words, learn about His kingdom, learn about His unconditional love on the cross of Calvary, learn about His salvation, which is initiated by God to resurrect the whole humankind from the bondage of sins. God wants the children to learn about His death and resurrection, in and through which God has resurrected us from the bondage of sins. Therefore, dearly beloved, for this nurturing, God has anointed all of us. That's how Jesus Christ very clearly says, "Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me." Jesus said even in Matthew's Gospel 19:14 and also in Ephesians 6:4, the Paul very clearly says, "Parents, do not treat your children in such a way as to make them angry. Instead, bring them up with Christian discipline and instructions." Therefore, the nurturing the little children with the word of God is the purpose of God, is the anointment of God Almighty, is the call of God Almighty to teachers and also to parents and grandparents and the congregation. Therefore, this is a great important aspect of the ministry of the church. This is time God reminds us by saying, "Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me." Our attitude, our witness, our busyness, our expressions, our communications, conversations with them must not hinder them, but continue to bring the children to the presence of God Almighty for the blessings of God upon the lives of the children. The book of Proverbs, chapter 22, verse 6 says, "Train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it." Therefore, nurturing the children is not made by human, but it is a call of God, a call to parents, call to grandparents, call to congregation, a call to whole world to nurture the children and introduce the living God to the children. Dearly beloved people of God, as we celebrate the annual day 2024 of the Sunday School, remember that God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, very clearly said, "Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me." Your time, your busyness, your schedule should not hinder the children in bringing them to learn about the Word of God. The Word of God really creates and recreates our lives, transforms our lives, and strengthens the life of every human. Therefore, dearly beloved, at the end, I would like to remind all of us that Jesus Christ very clearly said, "Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Garu. I now invite our Sunday School Superintendent, Dr. Grace, to give us the annual report of this year. give thanks to the Lord for His good and His mercy endures forever. Good evening, everyone, and I truly thank God for this beautiful evening. I want to begin on a personal note. I was raised in a small coastal town where we worshipped in a beautiful C.S.I. church, which was actually right in the middle of a cemetery. Unfortunately, there was never a Sunday school. I never knew the Sunday school songs, much less the general devotions. As I reflect on the Sunday school of this church, I want to tell each one of you, dear children, that you are so blessed to have a Sunday school which has been running so faithfully for several decades. Our praise and worship session is indeed a vibrant one where our children glorify God through their joyful singing. I present to you our worship team. Let me begin with Jennifer, our worship team leader. Can we all put our hands together? Then we have Joash, Rohan, and Martina. Thank you, kids. Up next, we have our singing and action team. And all these children put in a lot of effort Sunday after Sunday in running of this unit. The verse, all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, being the bedrock of our vision this year. A well-thought-out annual calendar was prepared for general devotions. I'm sorry, technically a week. Rohan, I might need your help, please. Can we move to the slide where we have the general devotions, please? Yes, I'm sorry about it. Okay, the verse, all scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, was a bedrock of our vision this year. A well-thought-out annual calendar was prepared for general devotions. And these devotions focused on giving an overview of the Old Testament, progressing from one book to another. I'm truly grateful to our teachers and parishioners for diligently contributing to these devotions. Okay, I think I'll move ahead. Yeah. In the past few months, our children have participated in many inter-church competitions held at the city level. One such was a Bible competition held by the United Christmas Celebrations, where 8 teams participated from our church. It was indeed a proud moment to have won first prize in 2 categories, in inters and seniors. Well, we have here our prize winners. We truly appreciate the committed efforts of Mrs. Usha Manohar, Mrs. Sujata Madhukar, Mrs. Govardhani and Mrs. Rebecca Salome in training our children. Another such competition was held by CFC, where close to 30 children from our church participated in various categories, and 2 of our children won the prizes. You can see the prize winners over there. And more recently, about 25 children from our church participated in the CSI Marvels conducted by the Town DCC, Diocese of Medak CSI. We are happy to share that these children that you see over there have bagged prizes in various categories.
In addition, there was also an in-house art and craft competition where all our children wore their artistic hats and glorified God through their artwork based on biblical themes. These handcrafted items made their way to the Sunday school stall at the Harvest Festival, which was well coordinated by our teachers, Ms. Sandhya, Ms. Nidhi, and Ms. Navya. There were also many other creative and exciting stalls put up by our enthusiastic children. World Sunday School Day was observed on the 5th of November. Our children presented a short play on the Noah's Ark titled The Rainbow, declaring the everlasting covenant between God and all the living creatures on the face of the earth. I am thankful to our teachers, Mrs. Julie, Mrs. Geeta Salome, Mrs. Nidhi, and Ms. Beulah, who greatly assisted in the execution of this kit. And sometime in December, the Sunday School celebrated Christmas, featuring a captivating musical drama titled Christ Revealed, the New in the Old, pointing to the prophecies of the birth of Christ in the Old Testament and connecting them to the New Testament. This meaningful play was scripted and passionately directed by Dr. Anina Abraham, meaning and ably assisted by Mrs. Junia George. It was truly a visual delight to witness nearly 100 children, from tiny tots to young teens, effortlessly embracing the roles as they brought to life the timeless story of the birth of Christ. And before I close, I take this opportunity to thank our dear teachers who faithfully and selflessly served our Sunday school all through this year. I wish you could scroll to the pictures of our teachers. As I scroll through their pictures, I truly want to quietly thank them. That's our senior class teachers. Yes, thank you, dear teachers. In closing, serving the children and nurturing them in the Word of God has truly been a gratifying experience. I'm grateful to our pastors, Reverend Dr. Daniel and Reverend Sumalata, and the pastorate committee members for giving me the honor of serving the Sunday school of this glorious church. May God bless our Sunday school.
Absolutely. Starting strong, we have beginners class sharing Bible verses that they learned during their weekly Sunday school lessons. Thank you. Wow, that was great. After which they planned a lovely action number for us. God's not dead.
Yes, they were amazing. And the philosopher Nietzsche was wrong when he said God is dead. We just celebrated Easter. And our youngest members have reminded us that Jesus is alive and he lives forevermore.
He is indeed. And he invites us to fellowship with him and commune with him. The primary class shall now present the great banquet.
Let them come.
A certain man held a feast on his fine estate in town.
He laid a festive table and wore a wedding gown. He sent invitations to his neighbors far and wide. And the meal was ready. Hello everyone. The king has invited you for a wedding banquet. But what did the people say?
The master rose up in anger and called his servant by name, said, "Go into the town, fetch the blind and the lame, fetch the peasant and the pauper. For this I have willed, my banquet must be crowded and my table must be filled." So the master demanded, "Go search everywhere, to the highways and the byways, and force them to come in. My table must be filled before the banquet can begin."
For the rest of mankind, if we are slow and respond, he may leave us behind. He is preparing a banquet for that great and glorious day when the Lord and Master calls us. Be certain not to say,
"I cannot come.
Still don't want to come to the banquet, you're certainly missing something glorious.
Really?
Yes,
we will come.
Dear congregation, you're all invited for the wedding banquet. So let's prepare ourselves and make a choice to attend if you want to be in heaven with the Lord Jesus Christ.
Wow, that was a great job. I would like to ask a question to the audience. What are the ways through which we can show our thanks to God? By praying?
Yes, praise is extolling God, thanking Him for what He has done, is doing, and continues to do. So here is the junior class, praising God with instruments and speaking about the significance of the instruments from the Bible.
Thank you.
Lord. How good it is to sing praises to our God. How good and right to praise Him. Good evening, one and all. Today, we the juniors would like to recite Psalms 150 and tell you all about how praise precedes to victory and joy, and that we all experience God's presence.
I will praise the Lord with the trumpet. When the Israelites heard the sound of the trumpet, they raised a great shout, and the wall of Jericho fell down, giving Joshua the victory. The trumpet signifies victory.
Harp. I will praise the Lord with the harp. Whenever the evil spirit came upon Saul, David took his harp and played for Saul, and Saul would feel better and the evil spirit would leave him.
It is good to praise the Lord with the tambourine. It signifies celebration. When the Ark of God was removed from Abinadab's house, David and all the Israelites were celebrating with all their might before God with songs and harps, lyres, tambourines, cymbals, and trumpets. Thank you.
As we know, trumpets and harps are special in the Bible because trumpets signal the return of Jesus Christ. As told in the book of Revelation, and playing of harp brought God's presence, and His hand came upon Elisha in 2 Kings 3:15. Therefore, praising the Lord with the instrument is powerful and can break every bondage. So, now let us all come together and praise the Lord with a song and instruments played by Junior. Peter on the keys, Anush bongos, Aaron clap box, Anaya tambourine. Thank you.
Trumpet, trumpet.
Let's give them a round of applause. Let's give them a huge round of applause.
Hey Smarna, have you seen JC and Evelyn around?
I think they're getting ready for the next performance. It is a depiction of the beautiful song, Via Dolorosa, the way of suffering.
I think.
Thank you.
John 16:33, Jesus said, "In this world you will face tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world."
Yes, Jesus overcame sin and death so that we can face the present with strength.
And what do we need this strength for?
To fight, of course, but not against men, but against the powers of the dark world.
Now, the senior class will present how we better fight the spiritual battle through the presentation, The Armor of God.
Check. Some people think that once you become a Christian, all your problems will disappear magically. But the Bible teaches us that Christian life is a battle against sin, the world, against Satan, and the powers of darkness. So, as children of God, we should put on the whole armor so that we may be able to stand against the enemies. But what exactly are the parts of this armor and what to do they represent? Watch on.
I'm John, average guy, leads a good life with little problems. Nothing much bothers me. I go to church every week. I know God. I'm safe and I'm saved. Or am I? Lord, help me. What do I do?
My child, put on your armor of God. Breastplate of righteousness.
And prepare for a new beginning in their lives, in church and society too. You, dear seniors, are the bright sunshine of our church, the seeds of plants that will nurture our church's future. I hope in the years to come, you will come back and meet us, tell us about your adventures and careers, and more importantly, tell those following in your footsteps in Sunday school that you will show them the great variety of things that a Sunday school student of our church can do and become. I'll request the seniors now who are bidding farewell to us to please walk towards the dais and take their places here on the stage. Farewell and congratulations for coming a long way and successfully traversing this journey with us. I will request our presbyter in charge, Reverend Dr. U. Daniel, and our pastor, Reverend Sumalata, to please come on to the dais and give them their sashes as a farewell gift, and also bless and pray for them. Thank you. So, in no particular order, I'll call out their names with a tiny little description. And if you can guess their names, please go ahead. Pleasant, humble, very earnest in her work, polite to everyone, and most likely the youngest in our senior class. Who do you think? Smarna Thomas. Smiles and dances her way into everyone's hearts, acts well too in plays, and is a great singer too. Who's that? Nataline Hannah. Very calm in class, serene, and not a single word spoken in class, but a dynamo behind the keyboard. Martina Joanne Jaden. Chooses her words very carefully, describes things very precisely, leads from the front, compares as MC, and once again, a great singer. Kareen Benjamin. Very quiet outwardly, but for sure, her mind is working overtime in class. Compares as MC too, and is also a good singer. Gretel Grace. If Rapunzel had another name, it would be hers, with those long, long, beautiful tresses. She's smart, dances well, and is also a good singer. Carolina Cynthia. Someone who assisted in handling the lyric sheets on the projector during the worship time in Sunday school. When present in Sunday school, very attentive, compared to in some of our functions, and she's made her appearance today after a few weeks. Who's that?
Elissa.
Elissa Niharika. Well, you know who's the last guy here. I should tell you something about him. Extremely polite, never says no, whether he does it or not later on. But a very kind-hearted young man, someone who would attend the general devotion in Sunday school and then peep into the senior class to see if any other boy is there. And if there are, it's an all-girls class, then he would run back to church. He's that shy. Emmanuel Prasad. So, we are very happy to have Pearline Prisha with us today, who was not able to actually come, but she's made it finally. Pearline, come to the front. She is somebody who attends regularly, listens very attentively in class, submits her work on time, and has won quite a few prizes this year for her attendance. Pearline, we are so happy to have you with us, though we are unprepared for you. But it is waiting. It is there at the back. Okay? You'll get your gift. So, thank you so much. Would you please pray and bless them before you leave this? So I will leave you with this verse, this key verse from Ephesians chapter 6, which y'all have been repeating over and over. This is for y'all, from Ephesians chapter 6, verses 9 and 10, which says, "Finally be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor of God," and you know what was in the armor, "so that you can take a stand against the devil's schemes." All the best. We'll miss you, but keep coming back.
Now, Evelyn, I have a joke for you. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Impatient cow.
Impatient cow?
Moo.
I think all of us are impatient for the next segment, that is prize distribution. Over to you, Julia, Navya, and Nidhiya, and Sandhya.
deacons to please come and sit on the carpet before we start the prize distribution. We will not be able to start it without you all, so please come. Seniors and interns, I cannot see you here. Can you please come and sit on the carpet? Beginners, raise your hands. Primary, very good. Juniors, interns, please come and sit down, interns. And seniors. Okay, are you ready for the prize distribution? You all had your snacks, right? You all can be much louder. Are you ready? Yeah! Wow, that's nice. Now we'll start. I now request our presbyter in charge, Reverend Dr. U. Daniel Pastor Garu, to kindly come on to the stage and present the awards to our winners. Let's all clap for Pastor. Louder. Okay, the first category is for the art and craft competition. Beginners class. The first prize in beginners class goes to Ashish. Let's all clap for him. Next, Marcus. Ashish. Marcus, be ready here. Catherine and Samson get back the third prize. Catherine and Samson, please be ready. Ashish, you can come. This is Marcus who got second, and next we have Samson and Catherine. Let's all give them a big round of applause. Thank you. Okay. Next, primary. First prize in art and craft competition goes to Sama Dheeraj. Sama Dheeraj. Second prize goes to Anna Faith. And third prize goes to Ashray and Ali. First prize, Sama Dheeraj. Second prize, Anna Faith. Third prize, Ashray and Ali. Thank you so much. Next, junior class. The first art and craft competition goes to Jaden Herald. Second prize, Tiara Philip. And third prize, Jerlyn Natalia. First prize, Jaden Herald. Second prize, Tiara Philip. Third prize, Jerlyn Natalia. Thank you. Next, inters. First prize in art and craft competition goes to Mura Tiana and Sherlyn. First prize is shared by Mura Tiana and Sherlyn. Second prize, Shimona and Yana. Second prize,
Shimona and Yana. Third prize, Manup and Nihal. Third prize, Manup and Nihal. Manup and Nihal. Manup and Nihal. In senior class art and craft competition, the first prize goes to Martina. Continue to cheer for all your friends. Let's clap for them. Second prize goes to Perlin, and the third prize goes to Natlin. Thank you, Pastor Garu. Let's give a big round of applause to all the winners and our pastor. I now request our pastor, Reverend Sumalata, to kindly come forward and present the awards to our winners of the next category, annual exam and attendance.
Take me to the rock, take me to the rock, take me to the rock, that is higher than I. Take me to the rock, take me to the rock. Take me to the rock, take me to the rock, take me to the rock, that is higher than I. Take me to the rock, take me to the rock, take me to the rock, that is higher than I. Shelter for me, yes, a strong tower from the enemy. Take me to, take me to the rock.
Take it. Take me to the rock. Take me to the rock. Take me to the rock. That is higher than I.
Take me to the rock. Lord, Come on, y'all. And take me to the rock. Yeah. And take me to the rock. That is higher than I. I'm gonna miss if I don't leave this old familiar place. Oh, troubles, I know they'll come, but I believe, Lord, you'll make a way. As I take each step of faith, you're gonna lead me by your grace. I'm pressing toward the prize.
will praise with all I am, every fiber of my soul. Every breath I'll ever take is because you made it so. And I will give you all I am, every minute, every hour. Won't you fill me with your love, with your strength and with your power? Oh God above, your love has opened up my eyes. Now all I see is you. That I have breath, Jesus, you're the only way, and there's no way I'm turning back. Oh God above, your love has opened up my eyes. Now all I see is you.
Once again, we are all thankful to God Almighty for His gracious presence and the celebration of Sunday School Annual Day 2024. I really appreciate the teachers and the whole team of Sunday School Superintendent Grace Didla. I request Mrs. Grace Didla to kindly come onto the stage. Kindly join your hands and appreciate her for her dedicated service. Due to her little higher responsibility in her office, she has handed over the responsibility. We are indeed very much thankful to you. I request the Secretary of Pastorate Committee, Ms. James Samuel, to come forward and give away the bouquet as a mark of thanking her and also appreciation and honoring her. Yeah, it's not there? Yes. Very specially, I thank parents and grandparents for sending your children to Sunday school, which is very, very important responsibility. I appreciate all the children for your participation, for your the way you have witnessed wonderful dances and songs, all you have learned in the Sunday school on the stage. God bless you, children. Once again, I thank you, Mrs. Grace Didla. On behalf of the students and the whole of Sunday school, I thank the officers of the pastorate committee and the pastorate committee for the way they have encouraged this Sunday school ministry in our blessed pastorate. Thank you. God bless you all. I request our secretary to kindly appreciate Mrs. Grace Didla for her dedicated and wonderful committed work in this children ministry. God bless you, ma. Let us pray. Loving Father, your love is so amazing, so wonderful. Gracious, loving Father, what we are not because of our strength, nor because of our merit. Gracious, loving Father, it is only because of thy grace, thy mercy, we are able to glorify thy name alone. We are able to experience thy gracious presence and the blessings in our life journey. Thank you the way you have blessed our Sunday school ministry. Bless the teaching staff, Lord. Continue to bless them, Lord, with thy word, and continue to bless them with thy gracious presence of Holy Spirit. Very specially, we pray for Mrs. Grace Didla, who has rendered the wonderful service to the children. Lord, bless her and bless her family. As we are journeying, Lord, in this great ministry that you have entrusted to us in the congregation, Lord, continue to lead us and guide us and strengthen us, Lord. May all the wings of the church, all the ministry that you have entrusted to us, bring in new blessings of hope to every individual and every family of our congregation. Thank you for thy gracious presence in this program, Lord. Thank you for the parents and grandparents. Thank you the way very wonderfully they have encouraged their children in sending to the Sunday school. Continue to bless them, Lord. Help us, Lord, to realize thy kingdom and help us to establish thy kingdom in our personal lives and also in the lives of society for thy glory. As we close this program, Lord, once again we thank you, Lord, and we commit ourselves, we dedicate ourselves into thy gracious hands. Continue to lead us and strengthen us to glorify thy name alone in all the given responsibilities. We also pray for all the volunteers, all the elders who have encouraged this program. Continue to bless them, Lord, for thy glory. In the name of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, and forever and ever. Amen. Now the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit abide and be with you all, now and forevermore. Amen. All say amen. Amen. God bless you all. Thank you, Amma.
Thank you, Pastor. I now invite you, who have got to propose the word of thanks.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. An annual day is a day where we sit down and remember all that we've done in the last 1 year, all that we've learned. And in all of this, I think we firstly will thank God because he's been with our little children. They've been able to attend a Sunday school, learn about him, praise him, and glorify his name. So thank you, Lord. We thank Presbyter in Charge, Reverend Hugh Daniel, our pastor, Reverend Sumalata, and the pastorate committee for always being there, for guiding us, for helping us, for supporting us in whatever requirements were there for the Sunday school. Then next is this special person, Miss Grace Didla. Children, a big clap for our superintendent. She truly is a calm person. You won't hear her scream or yell anytime, and she always has a smile on her face. Grace, we really enjoyed working as a team along with you wherever you are. And while you might be moving on with other responsibilities, we will miss you, but we hope to keep seeing you at Sunday school. Also would like to thank our teachers, our volunteers. Volunteers, are you here? Some of them are wherever you are. A big thank you to the teachers who have handled different age groups, prepared for your classes, always been there for events, for classes and everything else. Thank you, teachers. And then, yes, we have somebody special, the worship team. A big hand. Always energizing the Sunday school sessions and even today. So thank you, worship team, each and every one of you. God has blessed you with such amazing talents. And thank you for deciding to use those talents for his glory. I think with that, first we'll do a 3 cheers for this entire team. Miss Grace Didla, the teachers, the volunteers, and the worship team. Hip hip. Hip hip. Hip hip. Thank you for that. The next is you kids. You were there to Sunday school on time. Thank you, parents, for getting them on time and sometimes assisting the teachers in dressing and whatever help we needed. So thank you for getting them. And students, thank you for always participating and being energetic in everything you take up. Would also like to thank the principal of St. John's Church, St. John's Sunday Mrs. Rosemary, sorry for that error, because, you know, the school premises is given, and whenever we need support, they were always there, especially Upender and Hari. They are the people who also help us with the parking space, and every time we move, need space, they are the ones who create space for us. Special thanks for today's team. The sound and light, who do you think it is? Mr. Aaron and Mr. Joshua. Woo! And surprise for today, the live streaming team, led by our very own Jeffrey. Jeffrey and team. He's a Sunday school kid, but he's doing his role. And a special thank you to Philip and Rani, who are always supportive in every event and every aspect of the church. Once again, a big thank you to everyone, and over to the worship team.
Thank you. Thank you.